All right, we're looking at Record Sounds View Controller right now. And what I've done here is that I've embedded the code that we saw in the previous video in this file. Let me walk you through it. First, I imported AV Foundation, and then I declared an object of AV Audio Recorder globally. Then I added all of the code from the previous video to the Record Audio function. This includes a print statement, which will print the name and the path of the file where we have recorded our voice. Now, while I'm at it, let me add code to the stop audio function also. Here I will stop the audio recorder and then deactivate the audio session. I encourage you to Google and figure out why we need to add these two lines to our code. By the way, all of this code that we have added in this file is available in the instructor notes for you to play with. All right, I'm going to run my project. So now when I hit the record button, I get a print statement here in the debug area of my Xcode. This seems like the file name with the current date stamp that has been printed. Today is November 4th, 2014, and it's just past 12 p.m. where I am. So it seems like the file name is correct. Okay, let me try this one more time and see if the timestamp actually changes. There. And it seems like it does. The timestamp now is looking at 12 p.m., 2 minutes and 36 seconds. One last thing to notice here is that even though we've been able to successfully print the name of the file, we still don't know if our audio is being recorded successfully. Let's find out more about that in the next video.